Do you think Kyler Murray's a top 10 player at this point?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. I'm surprised to say it, but I do, and I'll tell you why. Basically, the whole top 10 is populated by quarterbacks. It's by so much the most important position that if you're one of the elite quarterbacks, you're in the top 10. And part of this is guessing, because you want to know the trajectory of the guy's career. For example, right now, you wouldn't put Drew Brees there because when you have two bad performances at 41, you have to start making projections, right? So I'm looking at this year so far, Russell Wilson, Patrick Mahomes, and based on their resumes as well, Lamar Jackson, Aaron Rodgers, Cam, Josh Allen, the way he's played so far, Kyler Murray. He's in that group. Who else would you put in that group right now? So, yes, if it was some player who'd been mediocre most of his career and had two games, that's one thing. But when you're the number one overall pick, who's excellent as a rookie, and then you do what Kyler's done in your second season when everyone's expecting you to ball out. A lot of people said Kyler might be in the MVP hunt. And he is? Yeah, I got to say, I think he's a top 10 player.
I'm not going to go that far. And the reason why I'm not going to go that far without even scouring NFL rosters is that if I can't even call you top four or five at your own position, I damn sure ain't going to call you top 10 in the National Football League.
That position's quarterback?
Well, again, when we talk of quarterbacks, it was like we got Lamar Jackson, Patrick Mahomes, Aaron Rodgers, and Russell Wilson. Not necessarily in that order, but you got four quarterbacks that you clearly would not put him above at this particular juncture. Now, again, the dude is special. I think he has tremendous talent. I think he has a tremendous upside. I think Arizona is going in a forward direction. And I'm even willing to give Cliff Kingsbury credit for it, even though he never deserved the job because his resume didn't warrant him getting the job. But it doesn't negate the fact that thus far this season they're 2-0. It doesn't negate the fact that in all likelihood they can end up being 5-0 before we really start paying attention to them because they've got Detroit, Carolina without Christian McCaffrey coming up. And then after that, the New York Jets. If that ain't a recipe for starting off 5-0,
better be 5-0.
I don't know what it is. They better be 5-0. So basically what I'm looking at it, I'm saying, okay, you have an opportunity. We'll see what you got. But to give him top 10 status overall in the NFL, we got to throw Aaron Donald into that equation,
yep,
along with various others. It could be a Khalil Mack. It could be somebody else. We've got to look at various teams or various players throughout the NFL before we adopt the mentality, top 10 overall. You're not even top four at your own position. Mm-hmm. How am I going to give you top 10
quarterback,
throughout
brother.
The entire league? I can't do that as electrifying as he is. I can't do that just yet.
Right?
Hell no. And guys, and hey, listen, I understand, man. We get all excited, and the door's been open for Kyler, right? We talk about his talent all the time. Cliff Kingsbury steps up and drafts him number one overall in the perfect system. But I want y'all to think about something. He comes into this year and we're saying Kyler Murray is going to be in the MVP conversation. And through two games, we are all excited about what Kyler Murray has done, right? 516 yards, two touchdowns, two interceptions, three touchdown runs, though, and a little bit over 100 yards. Let me talk to y'all about what 2018 was for the eventual MVP through two games, Patrick Mahomes. He had 10 touchdowns, six in one game, four in the other, and that trajectory carried him to 50 touchdowns and the MVP. Let's talk about Lamar Jackson last year, 8 touchdowns in the first two games, another touchdown rushing, over 100 yards rushing in one game. And so those are the stats that we're talking about when we're comparing Kyler Murray's second year, right, to the last two MVPs who won the MVP in their second year and what those dudes look like through two games. And those two dudes had to kick the door down for us to believe in them, because one was drafted 10th, and when Patrick Mahomes was drafted 10th and sat out for a year, we was like, oh, we don't know if he should have won before Deshaun Watson. Who is this guy that they're drafting with all this talent but all of these issues? He kicked the door down. He earned his respect. Lamar Jackson, they had to move back into the first round to draft him. People didn't even think he should be playing quarterback. Should he be a wide receiver? He had to kick the door down. And I get it. We are ready to receive Kyler. We want Kyler to be these things. Patrick Peterson talks about him glowingly. DeAndre Hopkins talks about him glowingly. But those ain't top 10 stats. Those ain't really top 10 quarterback stats. Those are, you have a lot of talent. Arizona really sucks most of the time. You're 2-0 and you've played well. That ain't kick the door down stats. And it is not an indictment on Kyler Murray. I think he's going to be really good and in the MVP conversation one day. This ain't the day.
Ryan, you make a compelling case. I have to admit it. And I'll also admit I can't prove it. I'm guessing. And you're right. I am basing it partly on what we've seen from young quarterbacks in recent years. The first time Mahomes really touched the ball as a pro. Same thing with Lamar Jackson. Look what they did. But I don't think I'm way off base here. Kyler Murray was the first overall selection. This dude put up crazy numbers in college. And he's so far undefeated. He's done what his team needed him to do, and he had an excellent rookie season. Like, you know, it's not easy to put up the numbers he put up as a rookie. And now he's doing it for a winning team. So if Stephen A. says, look, you got to take into consideration different positions, it's true. He's obviously not as good as Aaron Donald, Khalil Mack. You could say the Bosa brothers went on the field, Myles Garrett. There are others, but none of them are quarterbacks. Quarterbacks have a different impact on teams. And I believe that Kyler Murray will be in the MVP hunt this year, and he's the age he is and all that. He has his receiver.
Well,
my guess is he's top 10.
No MVP discussion if Arizona is in third or last place because Seattle and the Rams are above him. There's no MVP discussion. That's not going to happen.
If they're in the hunt, there might be. Yep.
Again, if you're talking about there, all of a sudden Arizona's in first place in the NFC West, and they've supplanted San Francisco, Seattle, and the Los Angeles Rams, that would be different. But the way Aaron Rodgers is playing, the way Russell Wilson in his own division is playing.
Saying real top 10 players.
Patrick Mahomes brings to the table. What we suspect Lamar Jackson will continue to bring to the table. There is no way that Kyler Murray is going to be in the NBA.
Look, Jared Goff.
Unless Arizona is in first place in the NFC.
If you'd have asked me two-thirds of the way through Jared Goff's big year several years ago, I'd have told you the same thing, and then I felt differently. But the NFC West is the best division in football, by far. Yeah. That's not
all
even close.
Right. Yeah. Let me get in here.
Attention, you're good.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.